This is from our Labour Weekend 2021, where we headed off to Ngawi in the beautiful Cape Palliser. So enjoy our video. This is Waimeha Camping Village. This is where we stayed for our two nights in Ngawi. We hired one of the cabins for the two nights. There is also the option of camping, obviously, and they have all of the facilities that you need to have a comfortable stay, and they are super family friendly. So this was our cabin, plenty of room for our family. The couch also folds out into a bed, and they also have cabins with bunk beds. We arrived just after 6 o'clock, so we pretty much just got sorted, had our dinner, the kids had a play, and we just settled in for the night. On Saturday, the next day, we woke up and the weather was beautiful. It was a beautiful day down there, yeah. And it was really hot, and we just had plans to go to the beach and just enjoy the beautiful weather. Down to the communal area and we got our breakfast all ready. Had a nice big breakfast before we headed out for the day. This is the kitchen and the communal cooking area, and is also the block where the showers and the toilets and whatnot are located. And then the playground's just out the back as well. So we headed to this beach first. This was just it's pretty much in the center of the Ngawi town, just a nice little sandy spot for the kids to play around, and did some surf casting or fed some fish. Fish had a good feed, nothing for us unfortunately, but the kids just enjoyed playing on the beach, and it was actually really hot, a little bit overcast, but it was nice and warm. And we spent a couple of hours here just hanging out, and then we went searching for a dive spot. And then after that beach, we went for a little drive to find a good dive spot. The coast was really busy this day. There were heaps of divers out, heaps of surfers out. It was just really busy. And we did find this spot. It was just by the golf course, behind the golf course there in Ngawi. And the boys jumped in here. There were a few other divers out there as well. But they jumped in to go get us a kai. And they got a pretty good catch, which will come up later. Meanwhile, the kids were just fast asleep in the car. We actually all ended up having a nap while they were out there diving, so we don't even know how long they were out there. They had their sleep, they were knocked out. And then when they did eventually wake up again, we just chilled out on the beach and waited for the dads to come back with our feed. Hey, I'm And unfortunately, we don't have any water footage because our GoPro is broken. That is missing from this video. Hence all the footage of the kids playing on the beach. But hey, it was a family trip after all. And then before too long, the boys came back with some pretty heavy looking catch bags, and as you can see, got a pretty decent catch there, plenty of crays out and about. So they came back with their catch. I think there was one small one that had to go back, but still a pretty mean day out in the water.
Do you remember that you have that one that's up there? Yeah. I gotta get away sometimes. Oh yeah. I got to get away. I gotta slip away sometimes. Oh yeah. I got to slip away to my special place. I woke up, yeah, on a cloudy day. Come have a look, you guys. In the back of my mind, I gotta work today. Couldn't find my shoes too loud. It's not gonna hurt you. Excuse me, sir. Me car broke down. Me missus left me with the baby now. And I can't make that day today. It might have to be another day. I said I'm sorry.
He's a fat bird.
So a really good catch from the boys, definitely happy with that. After that we headed back to the campground. They have this cool little area where you can basically clean your catch and just, yeah, get rid of all the mess that you don't want to take with you. The boys were pretty stoked to clean everything there so that it was all done and they didn't have to worry about doing it when they got home. And I'm sure anyone that dives can sort of relate to that, especially having to have such a long drive home. To be able to get that all done there, they were pretty stoked. So they cleaned up their mess, and then after that we headed off to have dinner. So while all that was going on, of course, the kids were just having a great time on the playground, just playing well. The dads were just sorting everything out. This place is super family friendly. There's so much for the kids to do just at the campground. They've obviously got these animals as well that you can see, and they're just like little pets really, and the kids just loved being at the campground. They've got the awesome playground, they've got these animals, and there's just so much for them to do and to explore. So if you've got little ones, highly recommend this place, because it was just so family friendly and there's so much for them to do.
I'm not sure what his name is. Don't touch his ears, darling. Nose, yeah.
So the campground actually packed out heaps on the second night, which was the Saturday. There were so many more people there. So instead of using the common areas, we actually decided to head down to the beach, which is literally across the road. We had a cook up on the beach, had burgers, and we just watched these guys out there surfing. I didn't get any footage of them actually surfing on camera, but it was really cool just watching them and just admiring the view and just to do something different other than eating up in the kitchen in the campground there, even though it is awesome. This was good fun. We went to the beach and we just went exploring. We toasted up some marshmallows, and then the kids decided that our charcoal fire wasn't cool enough for them, but luckily we made friends with these other campers on the beach and they let the kids go over there and roast some marshmallows, so that was really cool as well. And we met some really cool people just on the beach, and yeah, so cool to see how people live doing this sort of stuff full time. Pretty much us for that night, and the kids were wrecked, so tired. We settled in for the night, and then the next morning we woke up, had a light breakfast, lighter than the day before at least, and then we packed up our cabins and we headed off for the day. We still wanted to spend the day down there, as much of the day as we could, before driving back to Palmy. We packed up our stuff and then we did a little bit more exploring. They sell just cool little gifts and things like that, and if you're ever in Ngawi, the t-shirts that you'll see people wearing, it's from the shop, so just a little bit around here, and then we just kept exploring, and for a drive we were actually on the hunt for some seals, and then we broke into this little reserve, and there were seals everywhere.
Babies! Oh, look at them!
just went for a drive again. We couldn't leave without the boys jumping in one more time for another dive, so we just did a little bit of exploring, trying to find a good spot. And I'm pretty sure the kids were actually asleep again, so we were just cruising while they were sleeping in the cars, trying to find another spot. But man, just look at this coastline. It's so beautiful, so rugged, and it's just stunning. You could look at it forever. So yeah, that's what we did, just admired our views, and then the boys found the spot and obviously jumped in. And then went out, got us another kai. And again, the kids just enjoyed their time on the beach until the boys came back with their big catch bags again. We're quite big on doing this sort of stuff with our kids, especially when it comes to hunting and gathering our food. We just really enjoy showing our kids where their food comes from, and we try our best to hunt and gather the meat and the fish and the seafood that we do eat and enjoy. And it's just cool when the kids do eat this food. Rocco's favourite food is pawa. He absolutely loves pawa. And Ziki's favourite food is ikamata, which is raw fish. When they're eating these foods, they know exactly where they have come from. So we really enjoy these family dive trips. Obviously, my husband, he does a lot of diving and hunting on his own. But yeah, when it does come to doing this stuff as a family, we definitely like to take advantage of it, and just can't wait for the day that the boys can jump in as well, and they can go and collect the feed for themselves. But yeah, even just seeing them like touch the crays and not be scared of it and all that sort of stuff, it's so rewarding, and that's why we do this and that's why we love it. So if you're a keen hunter, gatherer, diver, get your kids out there and get them around it, because it's so good for them, and get your whole family involved, because just makes it that much better. Guy was obviously a little bit too small, so off Ziki went to go and chuck him back in the water nice and gently, as you can see. And then yeah, he was off back to join his cray family, and I don't know, maybe he'll be dinner for another day.
Trouble melts like lemon drops high above the chimney top. That's where you find me, oh,
and after that we actually did end up heading back to the campground again. The boys cleaned up their catch. We had some fish this time. I think we had some butters and blue moki. So the boys cleaned everything up, got everything sorted, and as I mentioned earlier, there is a cafe there as well, so we had a main feed before we headed back on the road to Palmy, and it was home time.
Clouds away. Ready, Rocco? Yay!
And that was that, the end of another successful family weekend. And that brings us to the end of our first family vlog. Hope you guys enjoyed watching.